Ladies and gentlemen, get a fat dip of that guac because today we are heading back in time to the Survivor auction. Some things just go together like salt and pepper, peanut butter and chocolate, and...
Jan, you like nachos?
Mm-hmm.
What goes with
Beer.
Nachos?
Beer!
You're on the right track.
Tacos! What?
What goes with nachos?
Enchiladas!
Margaritas!
Damn!
Yeah! Woman.
Remember, this video will end without warning, so if you see something you like, be sure to hit that like button down below and subscribe to the channel to be among the first to see new videos. It all began in the Australian outback when a young Aunt Burkish paid $200 for a tall glass of Herbert River water, and the Survivor auction instantly became one of the show's most popular and recognisable challenges, returning a total of 16 times before its torch was snuffed in Survivor's 30th season, Worlds Apart. Since then, Survivor fans have been crying out for the auction to return, but production have been reluctant to bring it back for two reasons. First of all, castaways have caught on to the fact that Jeff will offer letters from home to everyone for a fixed price, which became broken after Shireen bid $20, allowing the rest of her tribe to pay the same price. Secondly, the auction became predictable, with players holding out to spend all their money for a chance at an advantage. This meant that some players will get food items for cheap, losing the excitement of the auction. So, how do we fix these issues to make the auction a viable reward challenge to bring back in the future? We'll start by discussing letters from home. As harsh as it may seem, I think it's worthwhile to cut letters from home altogether. Family visit tends to occur earlier and earlier with each season and usually happens an episode or two after the auction. While we do get some emotional moments from the letters from home, we all love the auction for the fact that these hungry castaways will pay outlandish amounts to lick someone's fingers or have a bite of a hoagie sandwich. How good is it, T-Bird?
Good enough to make you want to slap your mama.
That brings us to the second issue with the Survivor auction. Advantages. During the 30s, Survivor has become oversaturated with advantages, which became evident in game changes when Sari was eliminated from the game by default, simply because she was the last one not to be protected by immunity. As we saw in Cagayan, players will hold out from bidding until the very end, taking their chances at rocks for a tiny scroll. And after Mike's charade in Worlds Apart, this can get ugly at times. The solution is pretty darn simple. At the start of the auction, Jeff simply says there will be no advantages up for grabs at this auction. Immediately, this means that players like Tony and Mike will bid on regular items, increasing the competitiveness of the auction. That isn't to say that we can't work advantages into the auction, though. Fans of Australian Survivor will know that the show has found the perfect solution by hiding clues within individual food items. This could mean that a player buys a plate of nachos with a clue hidden in a napkin, maybe they win a personal shower with a clue hidden on the shower curtain, or a jar of candy with a scroll stashed inside.
I'm sitting at the auction, minding my own business, when I see a clue inside my jar. Heart starts beating, I'm so excited, I don't know what this clue says.
There are many ways to incorporate advantages into the auction without outright offering one. Another, of course, being the proven method of keeping an item covered. Could it be a nice juicy steak, a bowl of grubs, or an advantage in the next individual immunity challenge? You don't know until you bid on that item. So there's two easy fixes to the auction, but how about we spice things up a little bit? In Survivor Thailand, the auction was held in a tribal format, something which was replicated on the most recent season of Australian Survivor. The two tribes attending the auction where they were given a $2,000 kitty. The twist? Only one person could bid on an item using their tribe's pool of money. What this meant is that some players could be selfish, buying one or two items for themselves, while others received nothing. Others who felt as though they were on the outs of their tribe could go all in on advantages. And competition could be driven for bidding within a tribe, causing rifts in camp. There are so many different dynamics within such format that make for an entertaining auction. Not everything is made equal, and that idea should be reflected in Survivor. So if they were to keep the auction going forward, perhaps another way to add further dynamics would be to have a quiz before the challenge to determine who gets the most cash to spend at the auction. Now, I don't think it'd be fair to make this a touchy subjects challenge, but rather just a simple survival quiz. There doesn't have to be an outright winner, just say 5 questions, and for each question you get correct, you get $100, meaning that theoretically someone could start the auction with a grand total of $0 in their kitty. What do you think of these solutions to the Survivor auction? Do you want to see the challenge return in the future? I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comment section down below. This video is now over. I hope you found something you liked. If you did enjoy this video, be sure to give it a like down below and please consider subscribing to the channel for all the fixins, new videos every Friday. You can crave some immaculate, tasty ribs, but you never know what you'll end up with. Maybe you'll come up with a bowl of grubs. Grab your torches, head back to camp. Good night.
Tender,
juicy,
lathered in barbecue.
Flavorful.
Easy, Woo.
Wow, woohoo.
That's how you do it.
Yeah.
Enjoy.
Who's gonna get woozy?
You have beer, too.